Our next topic is cost volume profit analysis. Here we'll be analyzing what will affect profits. Things such as changing costs or volume, of course, will affect a company's profits. It is a profit planning tool, but it's important to note that this is typically looked at in the short range. This tool will be useful in helping managers set prices, determine the product mix that is most profitable, determining what effect it would have on the company's profits if they pay a certain amount for a salary. There's all kinds of decisions that can be viewed in light of CVP analysis. Now, what this does is it considers the inherent relationships among the following variables: sales volume, selling price, variable cost per unit, total fixed cost, and sales mix. But if you think about it, this is a profit planning tool, and these are the variables that go into calculating the items in an income statement. Sales would be volume times sales price, for example. So we will be analyzing these variables and their effect on profit. But what we mean by the inherent relationships is that things will have an effect whether we want them to or not. So, for example, if sales volume increases by 10%, holding all other variables constant, total sales dollars will increase by 10%. Likewise, total variable cost will increase by 10%. By definition, total fixed cost will remain constant, and total profit will increase, but not by 10%. So notice that sales and variable cost will increase by the same percentage, and income will increase, but not by the same percentage. Now, as we conclude the topic, we will understand better what percentage profit will increase. But right now, these are the inherent relationships that you need to focus on. There are some underlying assumptions. First, you have to assume costs and revenues are linear throughout the relevant range. That makes our cost definitions true, meaning that the sales price and variable cost per unit are constant, and the total fixed cost is constant. Again, getting back to our cost definitions. Costs can be classified as either variable or fixed with reasonable accuracy. So methods like the high-low method will help you identify the fixed and variable components of a mixed cost. And we have to assume that we can do that reasonably well. You have to assume all units produced are sold and the sales mix will remain constant. Now, what we mean by sales mix is the relative proportion of sales that come from each product line. So you must have more than one product line for sales mix to have any effect. An example of sales mix might be that 30% of sales come from product A and 70% come from product B. We do need to understand just a few basic definitions before we work an example. First is the break-even point. Many of you have thought about break-even point before, but what we mean here is the level of sales where the company has no income and no loss. In other words, it's where revenues equal total costs and profit is zero. Now, companies may not desire to break even, but they certainly do want to know the break-even point. They want to know what sales must be achieved before we lose money. Target income. Once a company has determined their break-even point, they may want to build in some profit level that they are hoping for. For example, they might set profit to be $100,000 next year, or the goal may be 10% of sales. The margin of safety. Now, this is the difference between your actual or expected sales and the break-even sales. Practically speaking, it is How much could sales fall before you start losing money? Now, it does say actual or expected because you can do this in hindsight based on actual sales, or you can base it on expected sales if you're trying to project the margin of safety. The margin of safety can be expressed in units, sales dollars, or a percentage. The formula for margin of safety is your expected or actual sales minus your break-even sales. Again, it's looking at how much could sales fall before we lose money. If we want to express this as a percentage, we'll take that margin of safety and divide by the expected sales. Sensitivity analysis is really just looking at what happens if a certain variable changes. It's called what-if analysis, and it's very useful in analyzing different scenarios that could happen. For example, what if labor goes on strike and we have to pay a higher wage rate? That would mean our variable cost per unit would be higher. And what would that do to the break-even point? What if we have to charge a lower price? How many extra units will we have to sell? So the scenarios are endless here. We just want to identify a few. All right, we have three equations for analyzing CVP analysis. They are all based on this equation method, which if you look at the first equation there, revenues minus variable cost minus fixed cost equal desired profit. Simply stated, this is the income statement. Now, if we let SP equal sales price and X equal sales volume, then revenues become SP times X. Variable cost per unit times X will give us our total variable cost. We'll subtract total fixed cost to get desired profit. The next method is really just a shortcut method. It's called the contribution margin method. And the formula is the number of units is equal to total fixed cost plus desired profit divided by the contribution margin per unit. As you'll see, this is really just an algebraic derivative of the previous equation. One thing to note, if you use this formula where you divide by the contribution margin per unit, you will get an answer in units. The contribution margin ratio approach, the formula is sales dollars is equal to fixed cost plus desired profit divided by the contribution margin ratio. So it looks very much like the previous formula, only note that you will get an answer in sales dollars if you divide by the contribution margin ratio rather than the contribution margin per unit. Now, it's also worth noting and probably getting into your lecture notes that this is really useful if you don't have per unit information. That is, you don't know your sales price per unit or your variable cost per unit. Now, the graph of the CVP situation shows where a company would have a loss and where they would break even and where they would have a profit. And it just gives management a visual aid in assessing where revenue and cost lines will meet. And above that will be profit, and below that line will be a loss. Next up, we'll work an example.